Mr. Rusesabagnia ended up arrested in Rwanda after boarding a plane that he believed was bound for Burundi. How this happened has been somewhat of a mystery, which I asked you about earlier this week. But I want to play a clip of what you said to your advisors about this, which was, again, somewhat different. Let's look.
Is it news that Rwanda paid for the plane? I've seen it suggested. I haven't seen it. I haven't seen a government person confirm that. And bits of hard information that you may be the first person to say, I would be cautious about that, because he's looking for something that they could put out a press release about the interview or whatever. So they'll be looking for nuggets of hard stuff. But I think...
So you thought I should have, for example, said I have no idea who paid?
You do know who paid for the plane that transported Mr. Rusesabagnia to Rwanda. The conversation you had with your advisors was whether or not disclose it. Who did? Tell me who did.
Yeah, but did I tell you yesterday that I don't know who paid?
I'm asking who paid?
The government paid.
So the government paid for the plane that transported him. Yesterday in our conversation, what you suggested to me, if I understand you correctly, was that the government didn't play a role in transporting, in getting him here, right?
I told you, listen to me, I told you that there is a person who was operating with Rusesabagnia for a long time, who was an interest of our public investigation, criminal investigation department, who accept to turn him in, and the payment was to facilitate the transportation of that man, but it was to facilitate the plan of this man to transport Rusesabagnia to Rwanda. The government did not play a role in transporting him. It was facilitating this gentleman who wanted to bring him to Rwanda.
So essentially the government paid for someone else to trick Mr. Rusesabagnia to come into Rwanda?
Yes.